reverses it. Mayfield with it. Comes back to top of the key. Baker drives. Left hand is no good. Newman with the rebound. Alley to Glasper. Glasper, jump shot, foul line. No good. Newman with the rebound. Now it's deflected out. McMinn Central comes out with it. Kick out. Three-point shot is on the way. Is good. That's number 23, Mattia Massengale. Is good. Ball's deflected out of bounds off of McMinn Central. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Ball comes in to Stennett. We may not have been on the air for the start of this game. It's currently 7-2 McMinn Central. Ball's lobbed into Newman. Newman, baseline jump shot is no good. Rebound, McMinn Central. Lady Chargers. Massengale with the ball. Goes to Baker. GP looks like a sagging man-to-man. Three-pointer from the corner is good. Number 22, Mayfield. Ball intended for Newman. Yeah, they get it back. Reverse it to Ware. Ware's three-point shot is on the way. Is no good. Rebound, McMinn Central. Massengale with the ball. Goes in the corner. Baker drives. Pulls it back out. Baker again. Pull-up jump shot, baseline, no good. Rebound battled for. McMinn Central comes out with it. Three-pointer on the way is no good. Ball out of bounds off McMinn Central. It's going to be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. McMinn Central will go into their full-court press. It's a man-to-man, but they switch and double-team the ball. Ball tipped out of bounds off McMinn Central. 4:31 left to go here in the first quarter. Stennett to throw the ball in. McMinn Central, here comes the double team. Glasper back to Stennett. Means somebody is open. Stennett drives to the basket. Shots up. No good. Good look. Pull-up jump shot is good by Massengale. She has four. Molly Massengale, their leading scorer, averaging 21 points a game. Ball goes to Glasper. Glasper comes off a screen. Pull-up jump shot is no good. Rebound, McMinn Central. Quickly into front court. All the way for the layup is no good. Whaley with the rebound. Whaley up to Ware, to Stennett. Stennett drives, has the ball knocked out of her hands. McMinn Central comes out with it. Shots up and good by number 22, Maddox Mayfield. And GP wants a timeout with timeout. McMinn Central 14. Gatlinburg-Pittman 2. We understand that we may not have been, you may not have been able to hear us for the first two or three minutes of this game. So we have one official right now. The other two officials were stuck in traffic behind a bad wreck, so they've started the game with one official. McMinn Central is the team that eliminated the Lady Highlanders last year in the state tournament. And so far, their full court pressure has given GP fits. Ball comes into Burns. Burns breaks the full court pressure, gets it to Chloe Mahias, who is in the ball game now. They go to Newman on the cut. Basket's good. Good look for Maddie Ware. Ball goes into the corner. Ball's deflected. It's on the floor. The GP ball. Substitution for Lady Chargers. Cameron Loden into the ball game. Replacing Beatty. Ball comes into Burns. Burns to Stinnett. Goes to Mahias. Mahias drives over to Stinnett. Down to Ware. Ware thought about the three. Bounce pass into Newman. Newman shot up and good. She has four, and it's 14-6. Lady Highlanders on a 4-0 run. McMinn Central spreading, really spreading the floor. Pull-up jump shot. Massengale is good. Or I'm sorry, that's Mayfield. She has seven. Mahias with the ball. Drives. Is fouled on the drive.
Foul on number 22.
Stinnett to throw the ball in. Gracie Valentine into the lineup for Lady Highlanders. Ball comes into Burns. Over to Mahias. Back to Stinnett. Her pass is deflected. Gets it back. Valentine, three-point shot is no good. Called a foul on Burns. Baker brings the ball up the floor. Guarded by Stinnett. Pull up jump shot. Foul line no good. Rebound Burns. Burns into Newman. Newman kicks it back to Burns. Burns limited, playing with a cast on her left hand, so she's pretty much limited to right-handed. She was shooting fine in warm-ups with the cast. Ball goes into Newman. Newman shot is blocked, out of bounds. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. 1 minute left to go here in the opening quarter. Glasper back into the lineup, replacing Stinnett. Ball comes into Newman. Back to Mahias. Ball goes to Glasper. GP resets. Glasper comes off a screen. Drives baseline. Shoots. Ball's blocked from behind. Good look that time, but good defense by McMinn Central. Beastry traveled. Gatlinburg-Pittman ball on the turnover. 36 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. GP's throwing the ball away. Three-point shot is no good. Baker comes out with it. 24 seconds left. Layup is good. That's number 21, Sadie Gooden. Eight seconds. Ball goes to Valentine underneath. Newman shots up and good. Now that's the end of the first quarter with the score. Gatlinburg-Pittman trails McMinn Central 18-8. for McMinn Central. Massengale with four. Beestree with two. Goodwin with two. Maddox Mayfield with seven. And Mattia Massengale with three. For GP, Maddie Newman with six. Trinity Whaley with two for all of GP's 8 points. Again, starting the game with one official. Other two are supposed to be on their way or stuck behind a bad wreck somewhere. But the single official did a pretty good job first quarter. Play resumes. Ball comes into Glasper. Back to Stennett. Ball comes to Valentine. Back to Whaley. Back to Glasper. Glasper bounce past Newman. Good. And she was fouled. So far, they're not double teaming Newman, although help came from the backside that time. It's up and good. 18 to 11. Baker with the ball. Massengale off to good. Baker left alone inside. Left hand is up and good. Her first 2 points. Here comes the full court pressure again. GP breaks it this time. Ball goes in the corner. Valentine passes up the three. Ball into Newman. GP ball in their own basket. Stennett to throw it in. Comes in to Newman, shots up and good. <laughs> 20-13. Massengale to Beatty. Loading into the lineup for Lady Chargers. Baker finds Massengale cutting down the lane. She goes up and under. Good. She has six. Ball comes into Stennett. Stennett into front court. Back to Glasper. Glasper has the ball deflected. Newman gets it back in the corner. Whaley, three-pointer is no good. Over the back's going to be called on Glasper. Lady Highlanders look like they're in a 2-3 zone this time. It is a 2-3 zone. Massengale, three-point shot is on the way, is no good. McMinn Central with the rebound. Baker back to Massengale, back into the corner. Three-point shot on the way, no good. Ball battled for. Newman comes out with it to Glasper. Glasper, nice move, reverse pivot, good. Glasper went behind her back one side, then reverse pivot back for the easy layup. GP goes back man-to-man this time. 22-15. McMinn Central reverses the ball. Baker drives. Gets it back out. This time it looks 2-3 zone. GP switching it up. Running one-hander up, no good. Rebound Newman. Outlet to Addie Ware. Ware intended back for Newman. Stolen by McMinn Central. Ahead to Baker. Baker layup, no good. Rebound Burns. Burns into front court to Stennett. Stennett passed up the three, drives. Left hand is up and good. Great move by Leah. 22-17. Baker with the ball. Over to Beastry. Shot is up and good. Burns comes the other way. Goes to Newman. Newman, left hand is up and good. Massengale dribbles the ball out front. Drive, pull-up, jump shot at the elbow is no good. McMinn Central is ferocious under the boards. There's a lot of, it's very, very physical. Let me just say that under the boards right now. Baker to Massengale. Comes back out to Beastry. She reverses it to Baker. Baker drives, loses it. Hand check's going to be called on the Lady Highlanders. Baker in backcourt. Lady Highlanders man to man. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound, Ware. Ware gets it up court to Burns. Burns to Stennett. Beastry to the basket, shots up and good. Ball goes to Stennett, thought about the three. Goes high post to Newman. Newman reverses it, intended for Ware. Too high, out of bounds. Ball to McMinn Central. Mahias and Glasper back into the lineup for the Lady Highlanders. 26-19. .220 left to go here in the first half. Not sure what's. Okay. Whatever it is, we're straightened out. Play resumes. Lady Highlanders man-to-man. Baker with the ball. Guarded by Mahias. There's a back door. Misses shot. Beautiful play, but they didn't finish. Lady Highlanders, 3-on-2. Glasper all the way to the basket. No good, but she was fouled. So Malia will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Free throw, good. .26-20. Second free throw is no good. Rebound McMinn Central. Massengale up court to Gooden. Beastry with the ball. Beastry drives. Shot is up good, and she was fouled.
Foul number 32.
Free throw, no good. Rebound, Glasper. Glasper to Stinnett. Stinnett, three-point shot. He's on the way. Is no good. Jump ball, possession arrow to McMinn Central. Minute 30. McMinn Central walks the ball up the floor. Ball goes to Beastry. Shots up, no good. Battled far. Mejias comes out with it. Up court to Ware. Mejias drives. She's fouled, no call. I mean, even with just one official, that was pretty obvious. Massengale, shot is up, no good. Minn Central with the rebound. Back court, it will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Seconds left to go here in the second quarter. Newman back in the lineup along with Glasper, Gracie Valentine. Ball comes to Burns. They reverse it. Glasper thought about the three. Stinnett will take the three. Looks good. Is good. 28-23. Five-point game. That's the ball. Ball goes to McMinn Central. 14 seconds left. Shot is up. No good. Glasper with the rebound. Ball away shot at the buzzer is no good. Newman tries to tip it. No good. That's the end of the first half with the score. The Lady Chargers from McMinn Central, 28. Gatlinburg-Pittman, Lady Highlanders 23. We'll keep it here for a performance by the GP dance team, and then we'll be back with first half point totals and second half action.
Good job, ladies.
Marty Nosley back here at halftime along with Kevin Tierney, where the Lady Chargers from McMinn Central lead the Lady Highlanders 28-23. For McMinn Central, Molly Massengale with 6, Reagan Baker with 2, Katrina Beestree with 8, Maddox Mayfield with 7, and Mattia Massengale with 3. McMinn Central has 18 the first quarter, 10 the second quarter. For GP, Leah Stennett with 5. Malia Glasper with 3. Maddie Newman leads GP with 13. Trinity Whaley with 2. GP scores 8 points the first quarter, was outscored by 10, but then scored 15, outscored McMinn Central by 5 in the second quarter. Two things, McMinn Central's full court pressure gave GP all sorts of problems, and rebounding, McMinn Central just absolutely tenacious on the boards, particularly the offensive boards. So, we're ready to go. Ball comes into Glasper. McMinn Central drops back into, oh, they're playing man-to-man. High post, there's the back door to Glasper, beautiful. Give the ball to high post, and then Glasper back cuts her defender, gets the return pass for the layup, and it's a three-point game. Closest Lady Highlanders have been. Baker with the ball to Beestree. Back out to Mayfield. She reverses it to Baker. Now they come back to Massengale. Glasper deflects the ball. And McMinn Central throws the ball away. Will be GP ball. Great defense that time by the Lady Highlanders. And we also, if you're just joining us, we only have one official. The other two officials were stuck in traffic behind a bad wreck. He's actually done a pretty good job to just have one official on the floor. Ball comes to Stennett. Three-point shot's on the way. It's good. She has 8, and it's a tie ball game. GP man-to-man. Baker drives. Beestree, three-pointer from the corner, is up long. No good. Ware with the rebound. Ware over to Glasper. Glasper inside Newman. Newman turns. No good. Ball battled for. McMinn Central comes down with it. Beestree will take the three-point shot. It is no good. Rebound inside. Massengale. Good. She has 8. She's their leading scorer, averaging 21 points a game. Stennett thought about the 3. Just underway here in the third quarter. In a rematch of two teams that played in the state tournament last year, McMinn Central beat the Lady Highlanders. Glasper for a 3 is good. GP takes their first lead, 31-30. Baker to Massengale, drives, nice, inside, missed the layup. And there's going to be a reach in on Gatlinburg-Pittman. Massengale shot inside, no good. Rebound battled for. Whaley comes down with it. Over to Glasper. Glasper in the front court. Has her shot blocked by Massengale. 2-on-1. Massengale takes it all the way. The basket shot's up and good. Down court, Newman. Shot is up and good. Baker drives, gives it to Mattia Massengale. Back to Baker, to Massengale. This is Molly Massengale. Three-pointers on the way is good. Right. So back and forth. McMinn Central with the two-point lead. Ball comes into Glasper. To Newman. There's a travel. Newman wasn't expecting that pass. McMinn Central ball. Lady Highlanders. Stay man to man. Switching man to man. Ball comes back to Baker. Drive, shoots, and scores. Knocked out of bounds. It will stay with Gatlinburg-Pittman.
Burns checking in.
Burns coming in for Ware. And Naya Burns playing with a cast on her left hand, pretty much right-handed. Ball stolen underneath. Shots up and good by 20. That's 25. Who I didn't have on my roster. Stennett, three-pointer is going to be long. Rebound Newman, put back up no good, but she was fouled. So Maddie will go to the free throw line to shoot two. GP led 33-32. McMinn Central in a 7-0 run. Newman stops that, makes the first free throw. She'll have the second. Second one is no good. Mahias goes out of bounds off of. Oh, he missed that bad. She threw the ball off the McMinn Central girl and nobody went after it. It rolled out of bounds. It should have been Lady Highlander ball. Baker goes to Massengale. Guarded by Mahias. Takes it to the basket. Her shot was blocked. But a foul is called. Massengale free throw is short. She'll have the second. Second one is good. McMinn Central jumps into their full court pressure. 5-second count is on. Give the ball to Stennett. Stennett up court to Newman. And there was a foul. That really was unfortunate. Newman would have had a layup, but they called the foul while she was running the floor on the pass. So it'll be GP ball under their own basket. Ball comes into Burns. Gets it back to Stennett. Stennett drives. Up and under shot is good. Four-point lead for McMinn Central. Massengale to Loden. Back to Beastry. Beastry drives. Kicks it back to Massengale. There's a travel. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Ball comes into Burns. Burns into front court. Gives it to Stennett. There's a double team. Stennett gets out of the double team to Whaley. Back to Stennett. GP reset. Stennett dribbles left wing. Goes to Whaley. There was a foul, but no call. Massengale. And she's fouled going to the basket by Whaley. Whaley returning the favor. Whaley was fouled up here on the other end, but there was no call. Gracie Valentine into the lineup. Maddie Newman's getting a break. Beastry drives. Wasn't Beastry. That was 23. Massengale, Mattia Massengale. Ball out of bounds. It will go to the Lady Highlanders. Ball comes into Burns. Burns up court to Mahias. Mahias dribbles to the foul line. Kicks it back to Valentine. Back in the corner, Burns, three-point shot. Burns is good. Broken left wrist and all. It's a one-point game. McMinn Central with the lead. 1:52 left to go in the third quarter. Baker drives, shot's no good. Rebound Mahias. GP into front court. Out of bounds. Ball will stay with Gatlinburg-Pittman. Newman back into the lineup. 1:39 left, third quarter. Ball comes into Burns. Back to Stinnett. Back to Burns. Burns drives, gives it to Mahias. Back to Stinnett. Long three-pointers on the way is no good. Newman rebound, put back up good, and she was fouled. Here's the replay right at the end of it there. Maddie made the basket and was fouled. So she will be trying to complete the three-point play. Free throw is good. GP leads 42-40. Massengale with the ball into the number 31, Beatty. She loses it, but a foul is called. Ware and Glasper into the lineup for the Lady Highlanders. Ball comes into Massengill. Jump shot. Good. Ware. Back to Stinnett. Stinnett into front court. Underneath Newman. Newman. Shot is up and good. Great pass from Stinnett into Newman. Massengill. Down low, intended for number 31, Beatty. Out of bounds, it would be Lady Highlander ball. Lady Highlanders, 31 seconds left. Lady Highlanders lead by two. Ball comes to Newman, back to Stinnett, up to Glasper. Cross court, Ware. Ware, intended for Massengale, steals it. Layup is good. Massengale single-handedly kept McMinn Central in the ballgame this quarter. 8 seconds left. Stinnett drives. Left-hand layup is no good, but she's fouled. So Stinnett will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Massengale's had Molly Massengill's had 12 points this quarter for McMinn Central. She has 18 on the night. Stennett misses the first free throw. She'll have the second. 2.9 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. Second one is no good. Jump ball, possession arrow to McMinn Central. Pass intended up there for Massengale. Out of bounds off. It's going to be GP ball. 4 tenths left. So that's the end of the third quarter with the score. Gatlinburg-Pittman 44, McMinn Central 44. For McMinn Central, Massengale with 18. She averages 21. Baker with 4. Beestry with 8. Maddox Mayfield with 7. Mattia Massengale with 3. For GP, Naya Burns with 3. Leah Stennett with 10. Malia Glasper with 8. Maddie Newman with 21. And Trinity Whaley with 2. GP outscores McMinn Central 21-16 that quarter. Ball comes into Glasper as we start the fourth quarter. McMinn Central pretty much been man-to-man the whole game. Whaley, lob pass into Newman. Newman up, shot's good. Good hands by Addie Ware. That was a 5-second count. Great defense by Addie Ware on Mayfield. Stennett to throw the ball in. Ball comes into Ware. Back to Stennett. Over to Glasper in the front court. Glasper drives, gives it to Whaley. The bat, Leah Stennett will take the three-pointer. It's good. She has 13. GP leads by 5, 49-44. Timeout asked for by McMinn Central with timeout. GP outscores them to begin this quarter. Here's the replay. They try to double-team the ball, and Leah left just wide open. That's almost an NBA range three-pointer there, and nothing but the bottom of the net. So GP's outscored him this quarter 5-0 to begin this quarter. Conference at the scorer's table there. I don't know the official score. This official, actually, for being by himself, has, and you don't often hear me compliment officials, but for being one official in a game that's been fast-paced and very physical, he's done a very commendable job. He's done a whole lot better than sometimes what I've seen when three officials are on the floor. So hats off to him. Now, I may change my mind in these last 7 minutes and have a completely different opinion. But so far, he's done a good job. Baker with the ball for McMinn Central, guarded by Glasper. Baker guarded by Glasper. Goes to Massengale. Back to another Massengale. Three-pointers on the way. No good. Battled far. Tipped. Ball's loose. Baker comes out with it. They go in the corner. Three-point shot is on the way, but there was a foul. Number 21 for them. Gooden. Shoot to three, and she was fouled by Eddie Ware. Trying to get out on her, but coaches will tell you, you never want to foul a three-point shooter. Gooden will have the first. It's good. Second one, good. Third one is no good. McMinn Central comes out with it. Layup is up, no good. And they say it was off Gatlinburg. It will be McMinn Central ball under their own basket. There's a push off on Massengale. We'll watch it right here. Yeah, she pushed off to create some room. It wasn't a huge push off, but she definitely pushed off. Glasper in the front court. Back to Stinnett. Stinnett to Ware. Ware to Whaley. They lob the ball to Newman. Newman drives baseline, kicks it back out to Stinnett. Three-pointers on the way. He's good! GP by six. Massengale to the basket. Good. She has 20. GP done a much better job handling full court pressure. In fact, McMinn Central's backed out of it pretty much the second half. Stinnett to Whaley. Corner to Ware. Now they go into Newman. Newman cross court. Glasper three-pointer is no good. Jump ball. Possession arrow to McMinn Central. There's the replay. Nice pass out to Stinnett, left alone, and just drains it. 5:08 left to go in the ball game. Burns back into the lineup for the Lady Highlanders. Oh, they let her pass. It's a 2-3 zone. Lady Highlanders go zone this trip down the floor. And a foul is called inside on Burns, I think. Ball comes into Massengale, back to Massengale. Three-pointers on the way is good. I'm sorry, that's Mayfield. Maddox Mayfield. Ball comes into Glasper. It's a one-point game. GP leads. Ball goes to Burns. Burns drives, kicks it to Glasper. Three-pointers on the way is no good. Trinity Whaley with the rebound. Jump ball, possession arrow to the Lady Highlanders. 4:13 left to go here in the ball game. Been a well-played physical, but it's been a clean ball game. Pass was deflected and stolen off the inbounds. Jump ball. Now it's back to the Lady Highlanders. And I think she may have forgotten to switch the possession arrow. So McMinn Central, Baker with the ball. Guarded by Glasper. Ball's out of bounds. It will stay with the Chargers. Ball comes into Mayfield. Back to Baker. Goes in the corner. They reverse it. Beastry, three-pointers on the way, is no good. Glasper with the rebound. Over to Stennett. Stennett to the basket. Shot's no good. Rebound Whaley, no good. Jump ball. This time possession arrow is with the Lady Highlanders. 3:35 left to go in the game. Stennett into Newman. Has it deflected. They get it back. Glasper drives. Jump shot from in front. It's no good. Reach in on Whaley that time. So McMinn Central have the ball. Chance to retake the lead. Lady Highlanders man-to-man this trip down. Lady Highlanders have played 2-3. They played man-to-man. And they may have matched up a little bit out of the zone. Baker drives, gets it back to Beastry. Beastry shot up, no good. Rebound, Lady Highlanders. Stennett. Stennett into front court, gives it over to Whaley, over to Burns. Burns to Glasper. GP will reset. Ball goes to Burns. Burns drives back to Newman. Beautiful. Newman missed the shot. Ball's out of bounds. Goes to McMinn Central. Okay, we're going to go ahead and play here. Massengale backs Burns in. Shots up. No good. Rebound. Jump ball, possession arrow to McMinn Central. Ware's going to come in for Glasper. McMinn Central ball. Ball into Mayfield. Over to Massengale. Back to Mayfield. GP's in a sagging man-to-man. Three-pointer from the corner is up, no good. Rebound, Whaley, over to Stennett. Stennett comes out to Whaley. Goes into to Newman, backside to Burns. Burns, shots up, no good. GP's had some great looks, has not been able to finish. 2 minutes left to go in the ball game. GP by one. Timeout asked for by McMinn Central with timeout. 1:54 left to go. GP leads by one, 52-51. Two successive trips down the floor. GP's had pretty good looks, just wasn't quite able to finish. You see the GP huddle there. Head coach Katie Moore, assistant coach Conchita Owen, Mindy Brackens, Ralph Kidd, and Hagen Sims. Coach Moore done a tremendous job as head coach. I need to have it looked up before next Friday's games, but how many trips to the state they've made. And they have a real chance with this team to get back there this year. A lot of season left to play, obviously. Anything can happen in a tournament, but they're a very talented Lady Highlander team. As is the McMinn Central team. They have a shot to get back, too. Massengale drives. Nice dish. Layup's missed. Shot put up from in front. Mayfield is good. She has 12. McMinn Central back up by one. Ware with the ball. Back to Massengale inside to Newman. Stolen by McMinn Central. They lead by one. 1:20 left to go. Timeout asked for by McMinn Central. A full timeout. So a minute 13 left to go. McMinn Central leads by one, 53-52. Haven't mentioned yet, but you can see the rebroadcasts of these live stream games on channel 193 Charter Cable anywhere in Sevier County. You can go to GAT TV, GATTV.com, or you can go to YouTube. If you're interested in seeing, if you're watching a rebroadcast now and you want to know how you can live stream, you can go to the high school website on game day and get the link, or you can probably go to YouTube and find it on YouTube. Hope you're enjoying it. We enjoy bringing it to you. So, reset. It will be McMinn Central ball. Leading by one with a minute 13 left to go. Neither team in the bonus. 5 second count was on. They get the ball back to Massengale. They double team her. Ball's deflected. Massengale gets it back. Layup is good. That's what happens when you double team. If you don't affect a clean steal, somebody's probably open. Glasper drives to the basket. Turns, gives it back to Burns. Burns comes back to Stinnett. 46 seconds. GP trails by three. They don't have to have the three. Ball goes to Burns. Burns drives. Bumped out of bounds by off McMinn Central. It will stay with Gatlinburg-Pittman. 36 seconds left. Ball comes into Glasper. Comes off a screen to the basket. Missed the layup. Newman put back up. Good. 1 point game. GP's going to have to foul if they don't come up with the steal here in a minute. They're going to have to foul. There's the reach in foul. So with 14 seconds left to go, it's not the bonus. GP's going to have to foul quick. You have to have five fouls. You have to have five fouls, and that's what's changed this year. There is no more one and one. You have five team fouls in one quarter. You go straight into the double bonus, two shots, and it resets each quarter. So as we look up here now on the scoreboard, GP or McMinn Central only has one team foul. GP's going to have to foul them four more times in 14 seconds to get them into the bonus. I think that's something that just snuck up on everybody, that there were not more team fouls than that on. No, let me go back here. I'm sorry, I'm on the wrong side of the board. GP has four team fouls. The next foul will put McMinn Central in the bonus. My bad, I'm looking at the wrong side there. The next team foul will put McMinn Central at the bonus. But that is a new rule. No more one and ones. I sort of missed the pressure of having a front end of a one and one at the end of the game. But every foul after you have five team fouls is a two-shot foul. So So GP will get try to get the steal. If they don't, they have to immediately foul. And they foul off the inbounds. So no time comes off the clock. And this is this Baker? Baker will go to the free throw line. These will be her first free throws tonight. First one is good. So it's a two-point game. But Baker will have the second. If she hits it, it's a three-point game. Lady Highlanders will have to find a three-point shot. Second one is in, out, no good. McMinn Central comes down with the rebound. And Ware, three-point shot at the buzzer is no good. There's a foul. If we go back and look, and I've complimented the official, and it's tough from where he is, and he's calling it by himself, but Maddie Newman on the second free miss free throw, the McMinn Central player definitely came over her back for the rebound. I mean, it was a definite foul that did not get called. Massengill makes the first. We'll keep it here and give you the GP point totals. Second one's no good. Rebound Burns. That's going to be the end of the game. Final score, McMinn Central 59, Lady Highlanders 54 in the rematch of two state tournament teams last year. They may see each other again down the road. For the Lady Highlanders, Naya Burns with 3. Leah Stennett with 16. Malia Glasper with 8. Maddie Newman with 25. Trinity Whaley with 2. So, final score. They've already taken it off the board. 59-54, McMinn Central over the Lady Highlanders. We'll be back with boys action in just a few minutes. Marty Nicely back here at Jack Parton Gymnasium on the campus of Gatlinburg-Pittman High School for the second game tonight between the men's Central Chargers and your Gatlinburg-Pittman Highlanders. Both teams come into tonight with a 4-2 record on the season. No common opponents on their schedules. GP coming off a huge win against Pigeon Forge, a game in which Ty Glasper put on a shooting exhibition like I've not witnessed. He had 60 points, 10 threes. A lot of those threes were from NBA distance. And there's conflicting information. I was told during the broadcast, somebody texted me and said the school record was 70 or 72 with Donald Dodgen. The Mountain Press this week in their story said that 60 was the new school record and the old record was held by Donald Dodgen, but he didn't tell how many points the old record was. So I'm going to leave it. I'll have to do more research, see if I can find out if anybody knows for sure whether the 60 points is the new school record or whether Donald Dodgen did, in fact, and this would have been the late, sometime between 69 or 70 and 72, maybe 71. Probably late 60s, early 70s were his three years. So if anybody knows beyond a shadow of a doubt, let me know. Two other officials just walked in. The first game, if you're just tuning in, was officiated by one official. The other two were stuck in traffic behind a wreck somewhere, and this first official did the first game all by himself. And until the next to last play of the game, I actually thought he did a pretty good job to be calling the game by yourself. Missed a foul over the back on Maddie Newman at the end that ended up costing GP 2 points and keeping him from having the possibility of tying it up or going ahead with a three. But it's a good game. I anticipate that this will be a good game. As we mentioned, both teams with 4-2 records.
Now on the boys, varsity action.
It's time for the lineups. Listen to Scotty Henry. Carter Anderson.
Number 10, Jake Gooden.
Number 10, Jake Gooden.
Number
15, Will Cooper. And number 23, Raymond McCarty. And 24, Braden Beestree.
And now for your Highlanders, put your hands together. Number 2.
Now for your Highlanders. Number 2, Carlos Orr, senior. Number 5, Mason Harris, a senior. Number 10, Ty Glasper, a junior. Number 12, Wade Whaley, a sophomore. And number 14, Cam Richardson. Those are your starters. Up, battle forward. Ty Glasper comes down with it for GP. McMinn Central opens in a 1-3-1 zone. We'll see here in a minute. Ball goes inside. Whaley goes up. Foul, no call, looked like. Quickly into front court, McMinn Central. Number 1, Anderson misses the shot. GP, Carlos Orr comes out with it. Orr down the lane, missed the layup. Ball's out of bounds, touched by McMinn Central out of bounds, so it will stay with the Highlanders. Ball comes into Orr. Jump ball, possession arrow to McMinn Central. GP shows a 1-1-2-2 zone press. They double team the ball. Anderson almost loses it, gets it back to Gooden in front court. GP man-to-man. McCarty with the ball. Back to Anderson, McMinn central reset. Gooden to McCarty. Back to Anderson. Back to McCarty. There's a travel. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. No score, just underway here, first quarter. I'm trying to figure out this. It's a zone of types. It may be a... I'll have to watch it again to see exactly what it is, whether it's a matchup zone with some man-to-man principles. We'll try to figure it out. Ball comes into Whaley, or they reverse it. Glasper, three-point shot. Glasper is no good. Rebound, Whaley. The foul's called on the floor. Starting out, the officials calling it very tight. Ball comes into Harris, loses it out of bounds. It will be McMinn Central ball. GP, full court pressure, comes to Anderson. Two on one to the basket, number 24. Beastry with the basket, and he was fouled. He'll go to the free throw line for the three-point play. Fouls on Cam Richardson. Free throw is up and good. So Javier Francis in for the Highlanders. Or to Whaley. Whaley drives, shoots, scores. Shots up, no good. Battled for, no good. Harris comes down with it. Over to Glasper. Glasper in the front court, drives down the lane. Pull-up shot from in front is good. 4-3, Gatlinburg-Pittman with the lead. Anderson. Stepped on the sideline. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. It starts as a 1-3-1 at zone defense, and then they match up out of it. And it almost, it's a matchup zone. Glasper to Orr, three-point shot. Carlos, no good. Francis with the rebound, goes up. Ball's knocked out of his hands, but it hits the end line off McMinn Central. So Gatlinburg-Pittman will maintain possession. McMinn Central makes three substitutions here. Ball comes out to Whaley. Three-point shot's on the way is no good. Follows his own shot, gets it back. Goes to Orr. Orr, jump shot from in front is good. Quickly in the front court, McCarty drives to the basket, missed the layup, put back up by number 32, Will Benton, off the bench for McMinn Central. Whaley back to Glasper, thought about the three. Carlos drives, scores, no, missed the layup, out of bounds off GP. Will be McMinn Central ball. Cam Richardson back in the lineup, replacing Javier Francis. GP goes man-to-man full court pressure. Here comes a double team. They get it back to Anderson, three on two. Benton, layup no good, rebound Harris. Glasper gets it back. Pull-up jump shot just inside the foul lane is good by Glasper. GP leads 8-5. Anderson with the ball. Comes off a screen, drives down the lane, unobstructed, layup is good. Nobody switched off. Or to Whaley. Whaley inside Richardson. Nice cut down the lane to Orr for the dunk. Good, beautiful pass from Cam Richardson. There's a travel, and that looked like it could have been. That looked like Anderson could have injured a knee there, the way he slipped and bent back on him, but he's all right. Glasper. To Sutton. Whaley. Back to Sutton. Charlie Yazel in the lineup for the Highlanders. Goes to Glasper. Long three-pointer. Glasper is good. 13-7. Highlanders lead. Can't believe no foul was called. We got away there. But then McMinn Central got away to Benton. Benton shot up and good. He has 4 points off the bench for McMinn Central. Yazel in the front court gives it to Orr. Back to Yazel. Cross court Whaley. Whaley drives. Up and under is good. McMinn Central really gets back down the floor in a hurry. Long three-pointer is no good. Rebound battled for. GP comes out with it. Glasper. Layup is good. Timeout asked for by McMinn Central with timeout. You see the replay here. Glasper comes out with it and gets his body just in front of Benton. Protects the ball, makes the basket. With timeout, 2:50 left to go in the opening quarter. GP leads 17-9. Next home game for the Lady Highlanders and the Highlanders is next Friday, the 15th, against Oneida. Start time for the girls' game will be about 6 o'clock. There is a boys' JV game before that will start about 4:30. But varsity action should start about 6 o'clock next Friday night, the 15th. Both teams travel to Seymour on Tuesday, the 12th, to play Seymour down there. But then be back up here a week from tonight. Full court pressure, McMinn Central. Breaks it, gets into front court. Benton backs Glasper in, shots up. Good, and the foul's going to be on Glasper. First foul on Glasper. Benton has 6 points off the bench. Number 15, Talon Peterson in for GP. Misses it, rebound, jump ball. Possession arrow to the Highlanders. Yazel in the lineup, number 24, Quinn Koikendahl. Talon Peterson, number 15, Seth Sutton. Ball comes to Yazel, into Sutton. Back to Yazel, over to Glasper. Three-pointers on the way is no good. Ball's out of bounds off McMinn Central. And it will stay with Gatlinburg-Pittman. Harris in for Sutton. Glasper to throw it in. Ball comes in to Peterson. Peterson back to Glasper. Glasper drives. Gets it back to Peterson. Peterson drives. Cut off. Gets it back to Koikendahl. Three-pointer Koikendahl is no good. Up court. Good hustle by Yazel, getting back on defense, knocking the ball out of bounds, stopping what would have been a sure layup. McMinn Central throw the ball in. Ball comes into Spradling. Back to Benton. Benton just backs the defender in and scores. Has 8 points. Ball goes cross court, Koikendahl. Koikendahl will take the three again, no good. Rebound Harris put up, no good. And Koikendahl going for the rebound, stepped on the end line. number 33, Craig Husky, into the lineup for the Highlanders. 17-13, Highlanders still lead. Last several times down the floor, they've gone straight to Benton. Benton's backed his defender down for layup. Spradling with the ball. Now he's double teamed, but a foul's going to be called on Peterson coming across on help defense on the backside. 3 team fouls on the Highlanders. Men Central into Spradling. Drives. Loses the ball out of no. Ty Glasper saves it inbounds. It'll stay with the Highlanders. Yazel into front court. Goes to Peterson. Peterson skip pass to Orr. Back to Glasper. Three-pointer Glasper. In, out, no good. Rebound Orr. Loses it. Ball's battled for him. Men Central comes out with it. McMinn Central loses the ball out of bounds. I believe that was Cooper. Loses the ball out of bounds. It will be Highlander ball. 104 left to go in the opening quarter. Ball comes over to Yazel. To Sutton. Give it back to Glasper. Drives on Spradling. Spradling's called for the foul. Carlos to throw it in. Ball comes into Yazel. Goes to Sutton. Back to Yazel. Goes to Glasper. Back to Yazel. Yazel thought about the three, passed it up. Goes to Glasper. And Glasper's fouled by Anderson. Whaley and Reagan into the lineup for the Highlanders. Thirty-seven seconds left to go here in the first quarter. Ball comes into Glasper. Glasper drives, kicks it out. Whaley, three-pointers on the way. In, out, no good. McMinn Central with the rebound. Outlet pass to Spradling. And a foul's going to be called on Whaley. So Spradling will go to the free throw line to shoot two. First one, good. He'll have the second. Second one, good. Ball comes into Glasper. McMinn Central still playing a it may be a triangle and two. I think it is. Reagan. Three-pointer's good. At the buzzer, no good. That's the end of the first quarter with the score. Gatlinburg-Pittman 20. The McMinn Central Chargers 15. For McMinn Central, Carter Anderson with two. Dalen Spradlin with two. Beestry with three. And Benton with eight off the bench. For GP, Carlos Orr with four. Glasper, nine. Wade Whaley, four. Ethan Reagan, three. Benton, the leading scorer for McMinn Central, is a big wide body. Came in off the bench, and they basically posted him up on the low block. Got him the ball, and he backed his defender in and shot layups. GP started running a double team at him the last time he got the ball. But Benton is a big kid. Roger Matute in the lineup for GP, a freshman. Then it's Whaley, Harris, Orr, and Glasper. Ball out of bounds. Off GP, it will stay with McMinn Central. Spradling to throw the ball in. Comes into Gooden. Oh, I'm sorry, comes into Cooper. Their numbers are hard for me to see. Cooper dragged his pivot foot. There's a walk. Will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. And we'll see. I said it looked like they were playing a triangle in two. They're playing man-to-man on Carlos Orr and Glasper, and the other three are playing a triangle, a three-man zone. That's exactly what it is. It's a triangle and two defense. Whaley drives, shoots, misses. Rebound Orr put up from in front. No good, but he was fouled. So Carlos will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Carlos, first one is good. Second one, no good. Rebound. McMinn Central quickly in the front court to McCarty. Drives baseline, shots up and good. Glasper in the front court. Goes in the corner, Whaley. Whaley drives, shoots, scores. He has six. Shots up and good by Beastry. Found the open man when Gatlinburg-Pittman double teamed. Whaley drives. All the way to the basket, shots up and good. Whaley taking advantage of the man-to-man on Orr and Glasper, splitting the triangle defense. There was a travel, no call. McCarty drives, loses it out of bounds, but no. Saved by Reagan and then stolen by McMinn Central. And a foul is called on. Foul's called on Reagan. Didn't see that. 15 Cooper will be shooting two. . 25-19, Highlanders with the lead. Free throw good. I don't know, official said something. Second one is good. GP with the ball, Glasper to Matute. Matute drives, kicks it to Whaley. Whaley drives baseline over to Yazel, back to Glasper. Yazel thought about the three, passed it up. Whaley baseline goes up. Jump ball is called. Possession arrow will stay with the Highlanders. Highlander. Ball comes into Mattu. Three-point shot's on the way.
It's good.
The freshman drains it. And Whaley is having to go to the bench. I'm not sure. I believe he's bleeding. Has a cut lip. So GP will have substitute. Francis comes in for Whaley. GP shows their full court pressure. McCarty with the ball. Three-pointers on the way. Beastry no good. Backside rebound is Benton, and he's called for a push-off. And then he gets the technical for saying something. So Glasper will shoot the free throws. First one is no good. He'll have the second one. Second one is good. The ball will stay with GP. Glasper, step back, jump shot is good. Glasper has 12. GP leads, biggest lead of the night, 10 points. Foul's going to be on Mattu. Second team foul on GP. Shot is up, no good. Rebound, Francis. Good, strong rebound. Ball up to Glasper. Into front court. Goes to Yazel. Back to Glasper. Over to Orr. Orr. Don't know who he was. He thought Yazel was going to come back up the line, I believe. Quickly into front court. Central, Cooper, pull up. Jump shot is no good. Rebound battle for Yazel comes out with it, and then he looked like he was fouled on a reach in. Beastry with the ball. Shot's good. Ball goes to Mattu. Three-point shot's on the way. It's good. The freshman has knocked down two threes this quarter. I've not seen much of him. Obviously, he's a freshman, but he's got a beautiful shooting stroke. Good form, bottom of the net. So with the timeout, GP with an 11-point lead, 34-23 here with 4:34 left to go in the second quarter. Remind everybody, you can see rebroadcasts of these live stream events on channel 193. Charter cable anywhere in Sevier County. You can go to gattv.com on your computer, or you can go to YouTube. Ball stolen by Harris. Goes to the basket. Shot's no good. So Harris will go to the free throw line. Free throw, good. Mason will have the second. Senior. Free throw, good. Spradling with the ball, and a reach in is going to be called. Fouls on Harris. Spradling with the ball. Tipped out of bounds, they say, by Spradling. GP with three substitutions here. Number 11, Ethan Sowen into the lineup. Sutton, Cam Richardson. Cooper down the lane, no good, but he's called for the charge. Good position by Sutton. So foul on Cooper. McMinn Central in the zone still. Ball comes to Glasper. 3-point shots on the way is good. Sixteen-point lead for the Highlanders. Ball goes to Beastree. Intended on the side, stolen by Gallenberg, stolen back by McMinn Central, but they say Gatlinburg was on the out-of-bounds line with the ball, so it goes to McMinn Central. Timeout asked for by McMinn Central. 3:33 left to go in the first half. GP with their largest lead of the night, 39-23. See the GP huddle there and some students on the bench behind GP. Play set to resume. It'll be McMinn Central ball. Cooper to throw it in. Comes into McCarty. Looking inside to Beastree. Can't get it in. Comes to Anderson. Anderson loses the ball to Glasper. Glasper to the basket. Misses the layup. Followed by number 11, Sowen. Hustling down court. Gets the follow-up. McCarty drives. Running one-hander, no good. Rebound. Rebound was Sowen. Up court, Sutton. Sutton gets it into Richardson. Back to Sowen, 3-point shot. Sowen is in, out, no good. Ball batted out of bounds by Orr. It will go to McMinn Central. GP shows their full court pressure. Anderson takes it all the way to the basket. He's fouled on the way to the basket. He'll go to the free throw line to shoot two. So Anderson will shoot two. They've really been able to break when GP goes to double team. The man throwing the ball in this case Anderson, just breaks in behind him and gets a return pass, and they generally have GP outnumbered on this end of the floor. Ethan Reagan into the lineup for the Highlanders, and Matute back into the lineup, giving Glasper a rest. Free throw is good. Makes them both. Sutton will be at the point now, bring the ball up the floor. Matute back to Sutton. Back to Matute. Matute drives, gives it over to Reagan. 3-point shot. Reagan is off the mark. McMinn Central with the rebound. Anderson intercepted by Orr. Orr wheels into the paint, dishes to Koikendahl. 3-pointer. Reagan is again in, out, no good. Good look. 2-on-1. McCarty running one-hander is good. Ball goes up to Matute. Sutton at the point, goes to high post to Koikendahl. Matute in the corner. Back to Orr. Orr, jump shot, foul line. No good. Gets his own rebound. Back to Sutton. GP resets, high post. Koikendahl, Reagan, three-pointers on the way. Is in, out, no good. Sutton, rebound, put back up, good. McCarty, two on two. McCarty all the way to the basket, good. McMinn Central is not having any problems with GP's press. Ball intended for Matute, stolen by. And again, quickly into front court. They get the ball to Beastry. Beastry to Cooper. GP stays man-to-man. They run a double team at Cooper. Into Beastry, shots up, no good. Rebound battled for, GP gets it, Sutton. Sutton takes it all the way to the basket. Left hand, no good. Out of bounds, it'll be McMinn Central ball. 53 seconds left to go. Glasper back in along with Yazel and Harris. GP stays in full court. What they've done all night right there. This time Yazel went with Anderson, but they almost get the steal. Jump ball, they do get steal. Three on one to Glasper. Glasper's up, shot's good. Ball up to McCarty. Layup is good. McCarty's had 8 points, all on fast break points here in this second quarter. Glasper into the paint, shot's up, good. Twelve seconds left. Ball deflected on the floor. They call a foul on Orr. I didn't see that. Looked like Orr was just standing there, but they call a foul with the body on Carlos. See there, almost affect the steal right there. And it goes on the ground. Orr's just standing there. That was a slip as Cooper makes the first free throw. It looked like that he got bailed out. He just slipped, lost the ball. Carlos was there, so they called the foul on him. Second free throw is good. Harris at the buzzer, no good. That's the end of the first half with the score. Gatlinburg-Pittman, 47. McMinn Central Chargers, 33. We have a performance by the GP dance team. Then we'll be back with first half point totals and second half action.
Good job, ladies. Remember, we got shirts for sale over here in Sporting and Mall on the same one. Don't forget about that.
Yeah.
Marty Nossi back here at halftime along with Kevin Tierney, where GP leads McMinn Central 47-33 for McMinn Central. Carter Anderson, four. Spradling with two. Cooper with four. McCarty with eight. All of them on fast break points. Beestree with seven and Benton eight. All of them backing in of his defender from the post, low post, and scoring. McMinn Central has 15 the first quarter, 18 the second quarter for their 33. They are 9 of 10 from the free throw line in the first half. For GP, Roger Mattu, 6 points on 2 3-pointers. Sutton with two. Orr with five. Harris with two. Ty Glasper with 19. Sowen with two. Wade Whaley with eight. Ethan Reagan with three. GP scores 27 points that quarter for their 47. GP is 4 of 6 from the free throw line in the first half. McMinn Central played some zone, boxing one, then triangle and two, and then they played what looked like straight zone. May have been a matchup. GP played primarily man-to-man. GP did full court press. Wasn't all that effective. They might have gotten one or two turnovers on it, but most of the time McMinn Central handled it pretty well and got some easy fast break buckets off of it. We'll see what adjustments are made here the second half. It'll be GP ball to begin the second half. Ball goes to Glasper, and it looks like it's going to be a triangle and two again, playing man-to-man on Glasper and Orr. That's what it is. Then playing a zone, three-man zone behind it. Whaley, three-pointer's no good, out of bounds off Glasper. It will be McMinn Central ball. Ball comes up to Spradling into Beestree. Beestree reverse pivot on Richardson. Foul is called. Shot was no good, but Beestree will go to the free throw line to shoot two. We said they were 9 of 10 from the free throw line the first half. First miss this half. Glasper pull up three. Goes in. 3 point. 50-34. 16-point lead. There was a carry. Not nice pass, though. Dish from Cooper to Beestree. That was a nice dish. Glasper to Reagan, out to Whaley. Whaley drives down the paint, shots up, no good. McCarty quickly out to Spradling. Spradling stepped on the sideline. Out of bounds, GP ball. And what the triangle two does, basically it means that wherever Orr or Glasper go, they get double teamed because one man's playing him a man-to-man, and when they get in a certain area of zone, the other guy guards him too, so it means a double team. Ball comes to Ray, or is intended for Reagan, intercepted by Anderson. Anderson backside, kicked out to Cooper, no good. Harris with the rebound. Up court to Orr, over to Glasper. Glasper drives down the paint. Tries to get it to Harris. Stolen by McCarty. McCarty, left hand up, is good. Down to 12 points. Reagan had a three, passed it up. Gives it back to Glasper. GP will reset. Goes to Whaley. Whaley to Reagan. 3-point shot. Reagan is good. Francis is coming in for Harris. 53-38, 15-point lead for the Highlanders. Highlanders stay man-to-man. Ball comes to Spradling, comes off a screen, gets it to Beastry, down to McCarty. McCarty drives baseline, shots up, no good, but he charges. So it will be GP ball. Ball into Glasper. 5:31 left third quarter. Ball was high post to Francis. Gives it back to Glasper. Three-pointer. Glasper's on the way. No good. Anderson with the rebound. Gets it to McCarty. Quickly in the front court. Intercepted by Whaley. Two on one. Whaley to Orr. Orr. Shot's good. Nice pass. Wade made the defender come all the way to him, and then easy dish over to Orr. Shot was blocked. Cooper went to the basket and was blocked. I'm not sure whether Glasper or Orr got that. Yazel and Sutton into the lineup for GP. Defense. 55-38. Anderson out to McCarty. Gets the ball to Spradling. Spradling in the corner. Cooper, three-pointer is good. Ball goes to Yazel. Back to Yazel. High post, Whaley. Turns around, goes to the basket. Good, and he's fouled. Strong move by Wade. I don't know how he gets some of those shots off that he gets off. Here's the replay. He has the jump shot, but he says, I'm going to take it to the basket. Splits two defenders, goes up, makes the basket, and is fouled. Wade having a strong game tonight. 10 points. Free throw, good. Ball's deflected. Cooper gets it back. Goes to Spradling in the corner for the three. No good. Out of bounds. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Gooden in the lineup replacing Anderson. Glasper over to Whaley. Whaley to Sutton. Three-pointer Sutton on the way. In, out, no good. Battled far. Ball on the floor. Yazel keeps it alive. McMinn Central finally comes out with it. Beastry over to McCarty. Three on one. McCarty drives to the basket. Good. McCarty has 12, and every one of them has been a fast break basket. Glasper comes off a screen. Tries to get in the paint, ball stolen, out of bounds. Off GP, it will go to McMinn Central. .334 left to go third quarter. Beastry backs it in, double team, kicks it out to McCarty. McCarty goes baseline. Cooper shoots from free throw line. Good. He has nine. Back court is called. I'm not sure. It was close. He caught it in front court, but you have to establish position in the front court with both feet. I missed the replay right there. McMinn Central with the ball. Chance to get cut it to 10. Gooden with the ball over to Cooper. Cooper backs in. Shot is blocked. Glasper. Glasper with the back, Bucket good. Goes under the basket, comes the other side for the basket. Matut in the lineup for the Highlanders. Beastry to McCarty. No good. Battled far out of bounds. It's off McMinn Central. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Peterson in the lineup for Gatlinburg-Pittman too. Glasper comes off a screen, drives all the way to the basket, shots up and good. There's the double team stop. That was, I don't think that was a kick. I think Ty had the steal there. That was not a kick. I think it went off his leg or his arm. But they called a kick. Bradley runs over. Orr standing there from the time he crossed the half line. I mean, there's no question about that call. Back into front court. They set screen both ways for Glasper. Over to Matu. Thought about the three. Loses it off his foot, but Peterson saves it. Tries to get it into Orr. It's stolen. Anderson with the ball. To Beastry. Baseline. Shot's no good, but he's fouled. Foul, I think, was on. Don't know who it was on. Beastry, free throw's good. Probably on Matut. Zero. Beastry will have the second one. It's good. ...62-47. Anderson into the lineup for GP. In, out on the three-pointer. Ball intended for McCarty. Gets it back. Out of bounds. Off. They say it went off GP. B. McMinn Central ball under their own basket. Mason Harris and Wade Whaley into the lineup for GP. McCarty with the ball over to Beastry. Beastry to Gooden. High post McCarty. Nice high low down to Beastry. Missed the layup. Battled for. Harris comes down with it. Over to Whaley. Whaley into front court. Goes to Matut. Down low. Orr. Back to Matut. Gives it back to Glasper. GP resets. Glasper comes off a screen. Goes to Matut. Three-point shots on the way. No good. Whaley. Looked like a jump ball. No call. Foul's called on. Called on Whaley. His second. 44 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. McMinn Central with the ball. Ball goes to McCarty. Tries to drive, cut off, loses it. Glasper gets it back. Glasper to the basket. Shot's no good. Put back up by Orr. Good. Quickly into front court. Cooper drives on Whaley. Has his shot blocked out of bounds. It will stay with McMinn Central. Oh, ball's thrown away. Orr comes up with it. Lays it in good. Just like that, it's 19-point lead. 10 seconds, third quarter. Cooper drives. Shots up and good with the left hand. Glasper at the buzzer. Oh, just short. That's the end of the third quarter. Score, Gatlinburg-Pittman 66, McMinn Central 49. For McMinn Central, Carter Anderson with four, Spradling with two, Cooper with 11, McCarty with 12, Beastry with 12, Will Benton with 8. McMinn Central scores 16 that half for their 49. For GP, Ethan Reagan with 6. Wade Whaley with 11. Ethan Sowen with 2. Ty Glasper with 26 unofficially. Mason Harris with 2. Carlos Orphans with 11. Seth Sutton with 2. Roger Matute with 6. So, fourth quarter underway. Spradling with the ball. Goes to Anderson. Back to Beastry. 3-point shots off the mark. Saved back inbounds to Anderson. Long Spradling 3-pointers. No good. Rebound Matute. Matute gets it to Glasper. Up court, Yazel. Back to Glasper. Glasper down low. Reagan, 3-point shots on the way is good. Anderson backs a man in. Beautiful move. Shots good. Glasper into front court. To Matute. Yazel will take the three. Good. Here's the replay. They find Yazel. Open. Long three is good. Good spacing by GP on offense that time. Cooper, Spradling, 3-pointer from the corner is no good. Sutton with the rebound over to Glasper. Glasper drives all the way down the lane, has his shot blocked. It will stay with GP. Well, that was a cheapie. They called a foul on Reagan. He basically fell down, cutting through the lane, and they called a foul on him. Ball back to Anderson. 3-on-2. McCarty goes up baseline. No good. Battled far. Who's it staying with? It's going to stay with McMinn Central. Comes out to Spradling. Cooper, 3-pointer off the screen, drops good. He has 14 to lead McMinn Central. Glasper, long 3-pointer is no good. Ball on the floor, McCarty. Cooper, 3-pointer's up, no good. Backside rebound, Richardson. Richardson to Yazel. 18-point lead for the Highlanders. Yazel tripped, no call. Glasper bounced, beautiful pass into Sutton. Tried to get it to Cam Richardson, but it was stolen by McMinn Central. Basket by Spradling. Then timeout asked for by McMinn Central. Here's the replay. He's tripped there, no call. GP gets the ball back. Nice pass there. And then he touch pass trying to go back to Richardson. Seth probably should have just gone up with the layup, but McMinn Central gets it. Hits a layup on the other end. Cut the lead from 18 to 16. Again, you can see rebroadcasts of these games. Channel 193, Charter Cable, anywhere in Sevier County. Or you can go to GAT TV, G-A-T-TV on your computer, or you can go to YouTube. We hope you enjoy the live stream. If you're watching this right now as a broadcast, rebroadcast, and want to know about how to find out about the live stream, go to the high school website on game day and you can find the link. And you can probably go to YouTube and find the link also. Just search Gatlinburg-Pittman basketball. Next home game a week from tonight against Oneida. First game at 6 o'clock. Lady Highlanders will tip off. Wade Whaley, bounce pass down low to Sutton. Shots up and good. Ball deflected by, but Cooper gets it back. Goes in the corner to McCarty. Drives. McCarty will drive, step through, no good. Putting back up, good. Then he's fouled. The putback was Spradlin was the one that made the basket. He'll have the free throw. Try to complete a three-point play. Shots up and good. .521 left to go in the game. Ball comes into Glasper. Up court, Sutton. Sutton down low. Whaley shots up and good. That's the way to handle the fast break. Wade has 13. Ball stolen by Orr. Look out. Duck by Carlos Orr. You could see it coming. GP back up by 19. Spradlin goes to Benton. Benton, outlet pass into backcourt. That's going to be backcourt. Will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Four new ones coming in for Gatlinburg-Pittman. We have Craig Husky, Mason Harris, Roger Matute, Peterson, and Orr. Matute over to Harris. Three-pointers on the way is short. Rebounds run down. Harris saves it. Back to Matute. Three-pointer is short. Benton with the rebound. Outlet to Spradlin. Spradlin, pull-up three is no good. Out of bounds. Off of McMinn Central. It will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Orr will bring the ball up the floor. Goes to Peterson. Peterson in the post to Husky. Husky goes up, no good. And it will be Gatlinburg-Pittman ball. Beastry back into the lineup, replacing McCarty. Ball comes into Harris, back to Orr. Peterson, back to Matute. Inside Husky. Husky turns, has his shot blocked. Benton comes down with it. Benton, all the way to the basket, shots up and good. .78-61. Baseline, Harris, jump shot. Good. Cooper gets the ball to Beastry. Back to Cooper. Goes into Benton. Double teamed. Back to Cooper. Three-pointer from the corner is good. Cooper with 17 points. Glasper back in, along with Peterson and Diego DeCourcy, number three. Matute with the rebound, back to Orr. Matute, three-point shot is no good. Foul is on Beastry. And McMinn Central has a player down. I don't know if it's a hip pointer. He landed awkwardly. So we'll have a timeout while they tend to head coach Rasheed Moore, assisted by Gabe Hinton and Noah Clinton. We mentioned next home game, week from tonight against Oneida, game time 6 o'clock. There will be a game at Seymour next Tuesday for the Lady Highlanders and the Highlanders. So if you have the opportunity to travel to Seymour and support the Lady Highlanders and the Highlanders. After the 15th, the home game, it's the last home game before the Christmas tournament. They play Greenville at Greenville on the 18th of December. Then the Smoky Mountain Christmas Winter Classic is here December 20th through the 22nd. So it may be, looks like it's an ankle or a knee. They're taking the player into the training room to look at that. So it'll be GP ball under their own basket. 3:05 left to go in the game. Ball comes into Orr, saves it. Over to DeCourcy, to Peterson. Peterson intended inside, ball stolen. Benton with the ball. Dribbles into a triple team, loses it. Peterson comes out with it. Over to Glasper. Glasper jump shot is up, no good. Rebound. DeCourcy up and good. Ball comes out front. Cooper, three-pointers on the way, is no good. Rebound. Matute loses it, gets it back. Ball goes up to Orr. Layup, no good. Matute, layup, good. He has 8. So, McMinn Central ball, 2:15 left to go in the game. GP up by 20. GP, bunch of youngsters in there now. DeCourcy, Koikendahl, Solon, Matute, Anderson. Ball's on the floor, picked up by Beastry, shots up and good. Ball comes into Matute. Koikendahl back to DeCourcy, over to Anderson, passed up to 3. DeCourcy will take it, in, out, no good. Rebound put up, good by Sowen. Cooper into the paint, shot is up, no good. Rebound, Koikendahl over to Matute. Into front court, tries to get the ball into Sowen. It's deflected out of bounds. Let's see, Matute is a freshman. DeCourcy's a freshman. Anderson's a freshman. Peterson's a freshman. Koikendahl is a sophomore. So a lot of young talent on the floor. Ball goes into Husky. Husky goes up, fouled. So Craig will go to the free throw line to shoot 2. 1:16 left to go in the game. Husky good. Craig is a sophomore. McMinn Central with several substitutions there. Highlanders going to go to 5-2 on the season. Second one is good. Ball almost stolen by GP. His charge. Husky with good position. Minute 6 left to go in the ball game. Peterson will bring the ball up the floor. Three-pointer, Koikendahl, no good. Tip. Peterson comes down with it, goes back up. Good. That time they called a block that time. I think he just didn't want to call two charges in a row. But 39 seconds left to go. Shot was good by Gooden. Second one good. Peterson to bring the ball up. Ball goes cross court to Anderson. Anderson pulls it out. Back to Koikendahl, 10 seconds. GP going to run it down here. Ball comes over to Anderson. That's the end of the ball game. Gatlinburg-Pittman with the big win. 90, McMinn Central, 69. We'll give you the point totals for GP. Matute with 8. Sutton with 4. Carlos Orr with 13. DeCourcy with 2. Mason Harris with 4. Ty Glasper unofficially 26. Sowen 5. Wade Whaley 13, Peterson 2, Yazel 3, Ethan Reagan with 9 on 3 3-pointers, and Craig Husky with 2. So, Highlanders win. We'll travel to Seymour Tuesday night. Support them down there if you can. We'll be back here a week from tonight, the 15th of December, where the Lady Highlanders and Highlanders will play Oneida. Tip off 6 o'clock for the ladies' game. Good night. So, for Kevin Tierney, this is Marty Nicely saying good night from Jack Parton Gymnasium on the campus of Gatlinburg-Pittman High School.